What's new in Revit 2024? Let's have a look. Hello everyone, Florian here and welcome to another episode of Heiser BIM. Grab your Steiner coffee and I thought we'd have a look at what's new in Revit 2024. We've just finished a big job that's been gone for a few years and we've been running it in Revit 22. And the main reason we essentially jumped from our five perpetual licenses of 2019 to getting a rental license was because we wanted to use Revit Collaboration, or Cloud Collaborate, whatever they're calling it, to allow us to work with other consultants and also for me to work in multiple locations, and that's been working really well. But now that this job's come to an end and we're in defects period, I thought it's time to look at what is new in Revit. So let's jump over here, guys. Join me for this journey as we have a look. Now we've got the What's New in Revit website here, and then if we look down here, I have Revit, and we'll try and play with it here. So let's have a look. The first thing is topo solids. Create topographic elements as solid geometry. Okay. What's the point of this? You can already do it. Well, let's go here. We'll just go new. We'll do the architecture template. And we'll just see. We'll see what it can do here. What have we got here? You know, top of solid elements represent the topography and site conditions of your model. Yeah, nothing new there. They can be created from imported CAD or CSV files. You can create a topo solid by sketching boundaries and adding elevation marks. You know, let's click here about. What's the difference? Parking, yep. Is it, okay, so it's actually modeled up solid. Ah! Okay, that's interesting. That could be a lot cleaner than just the surface. Okay, so let's try it out. Let's try it out here, guys. Okay, what do we have here? Topo solid. Okay, well, wait. I want to create it from a sketch. Let's do a boundary line. Cool. Okay, now we edit the sketch. How do we add our points? Hang on, let's go to 3D. So here we've got the top of solid. Here we go, add points. Maybe I can do that here. Boom, 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 boom. Level 0. Now, okay, we'll put these ones up. 500. Boom, boom. Oh, look at that. Look at that. 750. 1500. And we'll do one here. 2000. For the civil engineer that adjusted our grade under a building back in the mining days by half a meter that didn't make any, they thought it wouldn't make a difference. Okay. Ah, okay. Yeah, I'm liking that. Now, can I export it as an FBX? Let's have a look here. I'll just dump it on my desktop. I have FBX viewer here. FBX. That it? Is that what we just opened? Oh, we'll open Mesh Labs and see what I have. Oh, and a 3D viewer can use that. I think 3D viewer can. And there you go. Okay, cool. You can bring it as a solid object in. Okay, I like that. Let's play with the section box. Here we go. Nice. What about if I want the top to be grassland? Oh, look at that. Oh, wait, it's got layers. It's got layers of information. Oh, structure, grass, sand. Oh, this is nice. This is nice. Okay. Yep. This could be handy. I wonder if you'll ever get a landscape architect using this. Okay, that's great. Let's have a look at the next new feature. I can see how this could be quite useful. I definitely need to play with it a bit more. Revit dark theme. Okay, let's have a look at this one. Revit supports a dark theme for first level user data, including the properties. Okay, so file tab options, color. Okay, so we'll go here, file options, where is it, color, theme dark. Okay, here we go. Boom. There you go. We've got a dark theme. Very cool. I guess, you know, if you have to stare at the computer for hours and hours, it'll really help. Okay, nope. Yeah, I'm a fan of that one. That's great. Let's check out what's next. Align surface patterns. Okay, well, hang on. Use the align tool to align surface patterns on shape edge elements. Patterns can align across the entire surface or triangulated faces on individual or group. Okay. Good. That's handy. I can see how that's useful. I can see this being, well, the last job we had a curved ramp with carpet tiles on there. I could see that being useful for this. Yeah, no, that's a great idea. What's next? Cut geometry enhancements. Okay, what is this? Additional categories have been enabled to allow cutting in the project environment. The following category subcategories can now be used to cut and cut in the project environment. Okay. Where is it? Walls, wall sweep. See also cut geometry. Wait a minute. Is this just the cut tool? Can I just cut through this? You know, let's... No. They finally caught up to ArchiCAD. That's funny. They finally caught up to ArchiCAD. Well, I'm pressing ArchiCAD shortcuts here to have a look. Okay. So if I click on this, where is it? I'm used to shortcut. I don't have any of my shortcuts set up. We could cut. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh, you're kidding. Are you kidding? Oh, that's nice. But the sand doesn't follow down anyway. Or the ground. Wait, so is that how we don't have pads anymore? Is it slabs or floors? Yes, it's called floors in this one. See, you know, so many years of using Revit, and I still refer to stuff like in ArchiCAD. It's funny. What? Oh, what? Completely inside another? Oh, it has to... okay. So that's not working, is it? Okay. How does that work? What one do I want to cut? Okay, so it doesn't... It, like, cuts it out of it. It doesn't... project it up. Okay. I guess that's useful. I mean, you can get your models looking more realistic, can't you? Okay, cool. Oh, you can mass void forms and sweeps. Okay, that's what you'd use it for. Okay, what's next? Search in project browser. Okay. Search function is now available at the top of the project browser. The search starts automatically. Does it? Where's the project browser? Okay. Cool. Okay, that's going to be really handy. That alone is enough for me to want to upgrade using that. On really complicated jobs, that would make things so much easier. So much easier. Okay, let's have a look. What's next? Schedule revision clouds. Okay, you can schedule revision clouds. I mean, aren't they assigned already to a revision? Create revision cloud schedules to better review and manage all the revision clouds in your project. Okay. And the sheet they belong to. Okay, cool. Yeah, no, I can see how that's useful. Definitely see how that's useful. Link coordination models. Visually cross-check between models of various disciplines and phases of a project in 3D view. Visually compare collaboration models created in Revit or other modeling tools. I thought you can already do that. Link Navisworks. Or NVC files, or NWC files. Okay. Viewable and organized docs. Okay. So you can cloud link to these files. Okay. I can see how that's useful. I'm not going to demonstrate that. Snap points for coordination models. Yes. Use snap points to easily model in context between two references based on the coordination model points. Or to better position a coordination model. Yes, that is awesome. I can see that when you're coordinating steel. Like that exact example there. That's really good. I like that one. That's good. More path alignment options for freeform rebar. Okay. Now, I've actually modeled up all of the rebar that we're putting in all the beams in my house. I've learned how to do all of this, which is handy. Okay, that's good. That's useful if you're modeling up rebar. Yep, I can. Architects will never have to do that. Well, maybe I should. You know, I could be a drafty. Here we go. What are we looking at here? Bar bending details on reinforcement drawings. That's cool. You know how I did these. I did them all with like details and then just isolated these elements and then laid them out on sheets. That's how I had to do it. So I had to manually work around for it. But that's a good idea. Yep. Because that's what I learned. You know, we've got hundreds of LIGs sitting there that we've had to tie up, and Rachel's tied it all together for these beams. And we ordered it in bulk from a manufacturer that did it for us. Oh, here we go. Bar bending details and schedule. Okay, now that's nice. You could just schedule that off. Awesome. Yeah, look at that. The manufacturer would love that. Damn it. What? Why didn't I upgrade to this before? I did all of them manually. There's so many of them. So many of them in my little house. In my little house. Okay. What do we have here? I can't test these ones really easy, like the bar bending stuff, guys. Maybe I should upgrade my house. We'll play with it. We'll do a video on it. Creating multiple associations between elements. Custom physical assessment, analytical element association. Okay. Multiple analytical panels or members to a single physical object or vice versa. This isn't something that I as an architect would use, but I imagine it's going to be useful for all the engineers out there. Let me know in the chat, guys. Enhanced analytical loads. I mean, what's good is that they're starting to bring all of this analytical processes and methods back into one, which is really good, really handy. I'm noticing when I do this, I get a graphics card overload because my new background removal is causing some issues. Anyway, so that's good. Detailed results reports for connection automation rules. What the hell? This is not something I'm using as an architect. Cool. Okay. I can see how on a complex job that would be very useful, particularly for the engineers. Flow and pressure calculations for MEP fabrication parts. Wow. Okay. I mean, it's described in a product roadmap. You just need to get, the thing is you need to find consultants that can work in these tools. That's a big point of difference. It makes coordination really easy. Create energy analytical models by elements in the 3D view. Okay. That's great too. I mean, if this can do all the energy calculations that we're required here in Australia, that would be awesome. That would really be awesome, but I can't see it happening anytime soon. Autodesk Assistant Tech Preview. What's that? Let's have a look. Is that an AI thing? It better not be. Yep. New AI guidance assistance is available in Rivet Help. The Autodesk Assistant is currently a tech preview and is only available for standard or premium subscription customers using English Rivet. Okay. AI guided self-service and options to contact support. This is them. It's just a chatbot. It's just a chatbot. Okay. Cool. What else? Cloud collaboration cache management. Okay. That's probably something interesting. The Insight Tech Preview. Architects' insights on embodied carbon impacts, starting it with... let's have a look at that. The tech previews are openly available to everyone, as opposed to a closed beta. You can get involved in the solutions. Okay, carbon insights. This I want to look at. This, the embodied carbon, embodied energy in construction projects, it's something that frustrates me, is that politicians and those advocating for renewable projects, they tend to overlook all of these things. Well, they don't even know they exist. And they don't realize that often what they're proposing may not be the smartest solution. But, you know, it's good. We need to be able to start measuring and getting data on these things. That's fantastic. Cloud model collaboration cache management. Yep. Okay, that's useful if there's a disaster. You've got to know where to find the model if it all goes wrong. Okay, I don't mind that one. Texture visual styles. What's this one here? What's this one? Use the new textures visual styles to apply the texture of rendered materials without lighting effects. Is this just OpenGL? When creating a presentation or view, you want to show the textures of a material but without lighting effects or rendering. Okay, let's check that out. How do we do that? I'm assuming that's shadows. Textures. No, I don't want to save. Ooh! So, is it just OpenGL? Like, I guess. Let's get out of dark mode, guys. I think it's too cool for me. I think it's too cool. There we go. Okay. Okay, cool. What do we have here? Okay, a little texture on there. Brick texture there. Okay. Kind of reminds me of SketchUp, eh? Yeah. No, I can see how that's going to be very useful. Very, very useful indeed. And we'll jump over here. What else? What's next? Let's close some of these while we have them open. There we go. Save that RAM. Save that RAM. Draw order improvements. Draw orders of 2D elements in families is visually the same in the family editor as in the project when outputted in PDF print. Okay, good. I'd say that's a bug fix more than anything. Cool. Access coordination model object properties. Ooh, okay, I like this. So you can get the properties of linked elements, finally, because you've had to open them up separately in the past. That's good. Now, can you tag it? Can you tag it and pull it out? I don't have a model to test it, but I'm hoping you could. We'll see. Color books dialog. Okay, ooh, what's this? Color books dialog. Specify colors using third-party color books. Ooh, how do I test that? When am I going to change a color? Maybe material. Material. Watch it crash when I change something on the material. We'll go graphics. Color books. Oh, look at that. You can use Pantone colors and all these things. Okay. Yeah, I can see how that definitely, some people have really loved that. Honestly, cool. My insight on Rivet Home. What's this? Is this going to tell you how many keystrokes your workers do? Gives you insight on your software use and suggest improving your experience. Your command use by category in the past 30 days. Okay. Create objects dimensioning. Cool. I don't know why you'd want to see that, but okay. User interface modernization. Over 2,000 icons were replaced with the new modern visuals. I mean, it's different, and I'm starting to learn what these all are. It looks a bit cleaner and more crisper. I'm still only working at 980 920 by 1080p on my screen resolution. Let me know if you've got a 4K screen. I have one. It's broken. I was going to record in 4K, but the text was too small, to be honest. I guess, you know, I'm old. I'm virtually a boomer. Okay, what is this? New sample model and project templates. Okay. Rivet to twin motion enhancements. How's that work? Isn't that... I've got twin motion installed. Add in. Auto sync functionality has been added to the twin motion dropdown. Where's the twin motion dropdown? Once auto sync is enabled while in 3D view... Okay, where's twin motion? Is that here somewhere? It should be up here, shouldn't it? Structure, PDF. Ooh, finally a PDF. Oh, create PDFs directly. The amount of time, the years that you haven't been able to just spit PDFs automatically out of your CAD software is insane. I remember using GhostScript and all these other things and this rubbish just to get PDF printing. Anyway, add in, modify, architecture. Where is it? Is it under rendering? Settings. Nope, I can't find it. We'll have to look at it later. Great, and now. Now, because I have this, my task menu. Great, everything's going crazy here. Come on. That's what I have to do to get rid of this. Now, I'm assuming I need to install the add-on for Twinmotion. I haven't added it yet. So, okay. We'll see if that's any different. Dynamo updates, good. Dynamo player, okay. Pattern colors for structural. Improved steel connection to SDK. Run solder studies within seconds. Okay. Access sun settings from the ribbon. Cool. What else here? Resize all rows and schedules in place sheets. Place multiple... Ooh, hang on. Multiple views and schedules. That's interesting. Okay. Multiple views and schedules can be placed on a sheet at the same time by either dragging them from the project browser or selecting multiple items from the select view dialog. Okay, let's try that. Okay, we got these guys here. Let's drag them all and put them on this sheet. Oh. Okay. Yep. Yeah, okay. Yeah, nah. Imagine that for internal elevations. Did you see that? Yeah. Yep. Cool. That'd be a time saver. Additional resizable dialogues, scope box height, define loading sets, define boring, MEP fabrication stiffeners, network-based calculation for duct design, and maintain annotation orientation needed added to air terminals. Okay. So cool, guys. That's the new features in Rivet 2024. What are my favorite ones? I can see the topo solids will be useful. Dark mode, I can see, yeah, that could be useful, particularly if you're tired and been working for a long time. Aligned surface patterns, yes. I mean, there's a job I would want that on. The cut geometry enhancements, yep. I mean, this is just catching up to ArchiCAD. I remember ArchiCAD was doing this a decade ago. That's how we'd cut the topo surface, whatever it was called then. Search in project browser, yes, 100%. This is probably the most useful thing. Schedule revision clouds, I can't see that being that big an issue, but I guess, you know, I'm surprised you couldn't schedule them anyway. Coordination models, yes. Snap to coordinates, that's useful. I can see this one is good for the rebar drafters, these ones here. So a bit of love to rebar, which is good. Custom physical analytical elements, not much of an architect. I wouldn't need these. These aren't really for architecture. Energy analytical models. I mean, these are great. All this stuff is great. This carbon stuff is great, but it's not really applicable to Australia. Sure, you can use it, but you kind of need a specialist consultant anyway. I guess it's a good start. I will play around with the carbon impacts study, the embodied carbon. The texture visual styles, yeah, that's a good one. I can see that. Just throwing it up there on an elevation with the textures on there, looking nice and clean, that'd definitely be good. Drawing order improvements, I'd suggest that's just a bug that should have been fixed. Assess coordination model object properties or access. That is something I wish we've had for a while. The color books dialog, I'm not really that keen on it. Better to have it than not. The Rivet Home, I want to see what that is. You know what it is. It's so bosses can see your keystroke count. The interface update. Okay, I still remember when Ribbon first came into Word. I'm that old. The new sample project. Yeah, that looks good. I've had a bit of a play in it. So yeah, definitely some improvements over previous versions of Rivet. Nothing really groundbreaking, but some stuff that I'm happy with. You know. So guys, there we have it. Let me know what your favorite new feature is. Are you upgrading? Or are you going to keep running your projects in the old version? Thanks for watching. Check out Hyzerboom, which is this channel, or Hyzer Does. And if you want to support us, you can using Patreon or YouTube. You can use our referral links, buy our pocket squares, or call us if you need an architect. Take care. Have a great day. And I'll see you in the next episode of Hyzer BIM. Bye for now.